Hey everyone, it's Nick. Do you have an electric guitar? Maybe an acoustic guitar. I'll talk about acoustics later. But do you have an electric guitar that you've wanted to customize? Maybe you're not sure what to do, but you'd like to make it a little bit more your own. Maybe do something with it, but you're not exactly sure where to start. Well, today I want to talk to you about that because I've customized pretty much every guitar I've had since I've been 16 or so, and that's quite a few guitars. And I'm going to use this Stratocaster, my main Stratocaster here today, as an example of different things that you can do to customize your electric guitar and the different parts of it that you can do. Now, in general, there's various different things you can do to customize a guitar. You can customize parts that you currently have. You can paint them or refinish them or do something to tweak what's there. You can buy new parts and just replace parts. And you can also like actually create your own parts. You can make your own knobs, I suppose. Some people make their own pickups. I haven't really done that. Some people make their own, they actually take like wood blanks and make their own bodies and necks and things like that. I haven't done that. I have a few friends who've done that, but I haven't actually done that myself. But I will walk you through some of the things I've done with the Stratocaster just to give you some ideas of things that you can do and some things that I've done with this guitar. Now this guitar that you see me playing on the channel all the time is a 1998 American Stratocaster Standard. I bought this brand new in 1998. It was all black. I already knew that I wanted to customize it, and I left it black for probably about maybe 1 year before I actually refinished it. With my son at the time, we actually sanded it all off, sanded what we could, took some stripper and got all the rest of the paint off, sanded it, and did a few other body modifications to it regarding like routing this a little bit more so it's a little less of a curve, or actually a little more of a curve and a little less of a corner. And this body cavity in back right over here, it's like a nice smooth curve there. I routed that out with a hand sander. I think it was a DeWalt little palm sander. So that's what I did originally. Then I started putting different pickups on it. I have a couple of three different pickups over here. I have a Seymour Duncan JB Jr. over here on the bridge, which is actually pretty cool. I can get a lot of good sounds out of it, anywhere from super high gain to really, really clean sounds. Now this middle tone knob right over here is actually a volume control, a volume fader for the inner coil of this pickup. Now these other two pickups, I have them on two different lay sensors. I have a silver lay sensor, which is kind of a little more mid-rangey sound, and it goes pretty good with the middle pickup over there, middle pickup position. And I have a blue lay sensor, which is kind of supposed to be like a little 59 lay sensor version of it. They're both pretty good. I like them a lot. I think they sound really great for me, but you have to have kind of a heavier touch to get a good tone out of these, and I kind of play a little heavier than I should, just like as far as an attack-wise. And I can get a pretty good tone out of them that I like. Otherwise, I would have just got different pickups. But they're not for everybody. I've had friends of mine that are really light players. They play much faster than me, but they have a really light touch, and they couldn't really get a good tone out of it. It sounded really muddy. So they're not for everybody. I like them. That's why I have them on here. I've had a number of different pickguards on here. Pickguards are different things you can change. Knobs, I don't really change the knobs too much. I have before, but I've never had on here. Now, strap locks. I do perform a lot, and I don't like having guitars fall off me, and I've had that happen a couple times. So I do have different kind of strap locks on here. Now, these are the old school leather ones from the 1980s. That I still have on there, actually. They work really good. You just put your strap right in there, put it over the top, and that kind of just goes over, and it works really, really great. There's no metal parts to snap in and snap out. They work great, and I like them because they're kind of old and they're kind of cool. Now the back of this guitar, I actually leave that off. I'm not sure why. I read somewhere that it's supposed to be an open tone. I don't notice anything on there. I just kind of gotten lazy to put it back on there. It doesn't bother me to have it off, so I just kind of leave that off myself. So for my Stratocasters, I don't use the bar in here at all. So what I do is I take these springs and tighten them to the point where this is flush up against the body, and when I bend, it doesn't move. And I do that for a few different reasons, because I do use a lot of different tunings on here, and I don't want to have to readjust the whole bridge a bunch of different times if I'm going to change tunings. And also because if I break a string, then I don't have to, the rest of the strings don't go out of whack. So that's kind of why I do that. Another thing I do with this is I actually put locking tuners on here. Now I have Sperzels on here. And I like the Sperzels a lot. I don't know if I would get them again, but I've had them on here for like 20 years, so they work fine. They work good. There's no problem in there. They tune really well. They hold a tune really good, as most locking tuners do. The only thing, disclaimer that I would have is these little knobs over here. They're very, very thin, and when you dim, they can like kind of like grind into your thumbs and your fingers when you're turning them. It's a stupid thing, but it's just a little usability thing. It's not the best feel when you're actually putting them in there. Now, one of the many reasons I like Stratocasters, just besides the feel and the tone, is that they're so highly customizable. Probably the most customizable electric guitars that I can think of. There's so many different brands that make custom parts of that. You can even go to companies like Warmoth and buy your own parts and have them put it together, or put them together yourself, build your own guitar from them if you really wanted to. But as far as like customizing your guitar, I've always liked doing that myself. It makes me feel like it's more my guitar, and I feel more connected to it, and it's just kind of nice to have something that's a little more unique, that's kind of yours. So Those are just some quick ideas on some things I've done with this guitar. And I'll go into a little more detail on future episodes, and I'll talk about some other guitars I've customized and some of the ways that I customize my acoustic guitar that you can't do quite as much as to the extent, but you can still do some things on there. So let me know what you thought. Let me know if you'd like to see more about the customizing series. And like I said, I can do a series on then how I refinish guitars and how I've custom wire them, and how maybe some soldering tips on if you've never soldered anything before, so you don't screw your pickups up when you're actually soldering them. And I can actually probably throw in some tips as far as like setting the intonation on your guitar, so you don't have to take it into a shop all the time when you want to get it re-intonated or when it's kind of out of tune. It's super, super simple stuff that as a guitar player, you should just know how to do. It's easy, it's fun, it takes a few minutes, and you don't have to pay somebody $40 every time you need it intonated again. So let me know if how you customize your guitar, so if there's anything that you like to do, if there's any other things that you would like on the series. And that's about it. Talk to you guys later.